So don't worry. You will get your recorded class, right?
ओके सर।
और what you do is I'm go to YouTube. Go to YouTube. Saksham, please, all of you, turn off your video.
So what do you do after that?
Find out Dr. Umesh.
Yes, so just
Right.
them.
Yeah. I'm sharing my screen. I'll tell you here. YouTube.
I got it.
Give me a minute, please. Hello. 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 Can you hear me? Saksham, can you hear me? Arav, can you hear me? Are you here? Arav, Saksham, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
Right. So, have you got my YouTube channel, Dr. Umesh?
Yes.
And I think la first on the upside only you can see one video, Olympiad class 9th.
Yes, sir. I found it.
Yeah. So last two or three classes that I have recorded that are there on my YouTube, right? You can see from there, right? If you want to see that one, right?
Yes, sir.
So
Thank you, sir.
you'll be able to see that because all the classes whatever we are conducting here, I record it, right? Right now also I'm recording your class, right? Okay, so I'm starting now one new topic today. Okay, before I proceed, do you have any doubt? Anything that you want to ask?
No, sir.
No. Saksham?
No, sir.
Okay. So today I'll discuss about reactions, chemical reactions. I'll talk about chemical reactions, how reaction takes place. What do you mean by a reaction? Right? Can you tell me, have you ever seen any reaction? Yes, Akshav, you tell me.
Any chemical reaction?
Any chemical action in your kitchen, in your washroom, in your
Yes, sir.
lab, something, what?
So when we heat a mixture of sulfur and iron.
Have you done this experiment?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me then.
So basically, you take iron fillings and then you take sulfur powder and then you mix it together. And then you put in like a plate and then you heated in a Bunsen burner.
All right. Nippon, both of you, please turn on video. Why do you keep it closed? Okay. Turn on video. Yeah, that's good. So, Nippon, any doubt from the previous topic?
No, sir.
No. You understood each and everything?
Yes,
till,
sir.
Till now, we are going good. Right. So, today I'm going to discuss about something as a chemical reaction. Right. Nippon, you tell me, have you ever seen any chemical reaction?
So are you telling like practically?
Yeah, practically. Have you ever seen any chemical reaction?
No, sir, I don't remember.
Okay, in your kitchen, in your washroom, in your anything in surrounding?
So I can't remember right now.
Okay. All right. Can't remember. No problem. Just a second. Is digestion process a chemical reaction? Is the digestion process a chemical reaction? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Have you ever seen something burning? Wood burning, cloth burning, anything burning? Is burning a chemical process? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. So basically, chemical change means any process which brings some change. Chemically, they are different. Not physically different, but they are chemically different. That is called as a chemical change. Right. And the one in which there is no any chemical change, but only physically change, physical change is observed, we call it a physical change. Right. For example, water is evaporating. Then H2O, water chemical formula is H2O, that remain H2O. Right? That remain H2O. But chemically, it remains same. Physically, it is different. Different means it was liquid earlier, now it is a gaseous. Okay. So, I'm sharing my screen now. And discussing about the chemical reaction part. See, I have a magnesium ribbon. I hold it in the tong and heat it in the burner. This is what I'm doing in the lab. Right. So what happens then? What happens? What do we observe? Magnesium burns with a dazzling flame and white color powder falls down. That is a practical observation. Right. So magnesium is a metal and now it is chemically converting into magnesium oxide. I can say magnesium is a metal. When combined with oxygen, it forms a magnesium oxide, MgO. So magnesium is a metal and MgO is something like oxide. It is a powder we get. So chemically now it is different. So we say it's a chemical change that is observed. Are you getting me?
Yes, sir.
All right. Now let us take up one more example here. Here I have a zinc granule and here I dilute sulfuric acid. When zinc react with HCl, it forms a ZnCl2 and hydrogen gas, H2 gas. So zinc is a metal and it got converted in ZnCl2. So we call this as a chemical change. Not on the reaction, not on this reaction. Note it down. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, certain observation help us to determine whether the reaction has taken place. Change in state, change in color, evolution of a gas, or change in temperature. If any one of this is observed, we say that the reaction has taken place. Note it down. When you're done, please let me know. Note it down. Should we proceed ahead?
Yes, sir.
Now, the fourth sign that indicate reaction has taken place. Change in color, change in state, evolution of a gas, and change in temperature. That you have noted down already. Right. Now, when magnesium ribbon is burned, it gets converted into magnesium oxide. Right. So, how to represent it? Basically, I'm talking about representation here. What has taken place? I'm underlining it here. Magnesium plus oxygen to give magnesium oxide. Magnesium plus oxygen to give you magnesium oxide. Note it down. Only this much only. Only this much here. This is called as a word equation. This is called as a word equation. Write it down. Word equation.
Yes.
So one is the reactant. Reactant, that is before the chemical change. Product, what do we get after the chemical change? And the chemical equation indicate a reactant and product of a reaction. Just like I'm writing here, magnesium is a reactant with oxygen. It gives now magnesium oxide. So this is a reactant. And this is a product. Note it down.
Yes.
Now, understand here. Don't note down anything here. The word equation that I had written here shows change of the reactant into product. In between the reactant and product, I am writing here the arrow sign. So on the left hand side, we have the reactant and the plus sign between the two reactant. And similarly, in the product side, I can have more than two products. Like this, I can say reactant A plus B, and to give C plus D. This plus indicate that when we are adding the A and the B, I am getting C and D. Okay. So now writing chemical equation. Mg is a symbol for the magnesium solid state. Oxygen is the symbol for oxygen gas, and this I'm getting as a solid powder, MgO. This is called the chemical equation. Understood? Understood? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now I'm coming to the balancing of a chemical equation. Balancing of a chemical equation. See here, I have to balance an equation that is a hydrogen reacting with a chlorine, and I'm getting here hydrogen chloride. Right. This is an unbalanced equation. There are two hydrogen on the reactant side, so I make it two here. And by this way also, I'm getting the chlorine also balanced. This method of balancing is called the hit and trial method of balancing. Hit and trial method. Of balancing. Hit and trial method of balancing. Note it down.
Done, sir.
Done. Now, can you try this equation? Fe plus H2O? To give Fe3O4 plus H2O? This equation, can you try this balancing?
So done.
Tell me.
So we put a 3 on Fe.
Okay.
3 before Fe.
Mm-hmm.
And then we put a 2 before H2O.
2, okay. Mm-hmm.
And then we put a 2 before H2.
Okay. Check. 3 Fe both the side, 4 oxygen both the side, 4 hydrogen both the side. Good. It's a balanced equation. Every one of you got it now?
Yes.
Right. So we have got it now. Balanced equation here. 3Fe, four water molecule here. Fe3O4. Check your answer. Check your answer. 3Fe, 4O4. Got it? Now, wait a minute, please. Wait. This is called as a word equation. I'm talking about the second equation. Do you know the formula for the barium chloride? Convert into chemical formula type. Oh, I'm not sure. Wait. Can you see my screen? Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Right. So, how to write the chemical formula of this equation now? Second part, I'm talking about the second equation. Barium chloride, BaCl2. Do you know how to write the formula here?
Yes.
Okay. This one, and to give barium sulfate. Barium sulfate formula is BaSO4, and aluminum chloride is AlCl3. Do you know the formula of these compounds? Do you know how to write the formula?
Yes.
Right. So now, can you balance this equation?
So done.
Okay, now tell me, what should I do?
We put the 3 in front of barium chloride.
And 3 here?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then in front of aluminium sulfate, we leave that. And then for barium sulfate, we have to put a 3 then.
Okay.
And for aluminium chloride, we have to put a 2.
2. Let us check 3 barium both the side. 3 sulfate both the side, 6 chlorine both the side. Good. Very good. Got it, everyone? Nippon. Wait, let me check. Arav, you got it? Arav. Have you got this one? Okay, Saksham. Right. So make the second, third equation now.
So I should write the equation first.
Yeah.
So Na plus H2O is NaOH.
Mm.
plus alpha is 2.
Yes. Now balance it.
So we put a 2 in front of Na and then we put a 2 in front of water.
Okay.
And we put a 2 in front of sodium hydroxide.
Good. Is that clear, everyone? Arav? Nipun, are you getting this? You went out?
Yes, sir.
Right. So what we had done is we had written this word equation into the chemical equation. Word equation into chemical equation. Right. I'm going ahead. Don't worry, Nipun. We are coming back with more things.
Okay, sir.
Right. Okay. Wait. During a chemical reaction of atom, one element do not change into the other element. Means element do not change. Sodium remains sodium. Magnesium remains magnesium. Nor do the atom disappear. But actually, the bonds are broken and new bonds are formed. Bonds are broken. For example, if I say I have this molecule of methane, CH4, I'm reacting with the oxygen. Now it is forming carbon dioxide and H2O. Right. So you can see the old bonds are broken and new bonds are formed. So you can write during a chemical reaction, old bonds are broken and new bonds are formed. Right? Understood now? Now, there are four types of reaction that we'll discuss today. One is the combination reaction. When two or more reactants join together to give a new product. Then decomposition reaction. Then single displacement reaction. I'll go into detail of it, don't note from here. First of all, I'm starting with a combination reaction. See here, when single product is formed from two or more reactant, it's called as a combination reaction. I have two reactant here, calcium oxide and water. It gives rise to one product only. So we call this is a combination reaction. Write down the definition and example. Note it down.
Yes.
Right. Now combination reaction. You get sodium plus chlorine, they are combining here. Two or more substances are reacting and they form one compound. You can write the balanced equation. This element is already balanced. This equation is already balanced. Note it down.
Yes.
Right. Now, some reaction. Like in photosynthesis, carbon dioxide plus water to give glucose and oxygen. H2 plus O2 to give water. Sodium plus chlorine to give NaCl. In general form, I can say two or more reactants combined to give one product. The reaction is called as a combination reaction. Reaction is called as a combination reaction. That is called as a combination reaction. Understood? Noted down all these actions.
Yes, sir.
Now, let us discuss some more example. Carbon plus oxygen to give carbon dioxide. This is a combustion of the carbon. Combustion means burning. Burning carbon is nothing but we can call it as a coal or diamond or graphite. All these are basically pure form of the carbon. When we burnt it, we get the carbon dioxide. It's a combination reaction. Hydrogen plus oxygen to give water. It's a combination reaction. Note down the reactions. Note down only the reaction. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, combustion of the methane. Wait a minute, please. Combustion. I have stopped sharing for some time. Wait. Methane is CH4. Methane is CH4. And I'm reacting with oxygen. Whenever any hydrocarbon reacts with oxygen, it produces here carbon dioxide and water. Can you balance this? Can you balance this? Who will do it?
So done.
Okay, done. Let me know then the product then. Final answer.
So we put 2 before O2.
Okay, 2 before O2.
And 2 before H2O.
Okay.
That's it.
That's it. It's a balance now. 1 carbon both the side, 4 hydrogen both the side. Okay, good. All right. Getting me, Arav? Now we talk about the decomposition reaction. When I say decomposition, means a single reactant breaks into 2 or more simple products. For example, here we have ferrous sulfate. Upon heating, it is giving ferric oxide plus sulfur dioxide plus sulfur trioxide. It's a decomposition of the ferrous sulfate. Write down the only equation. Don't note down all these things. Only definition only. And then the one reaction. The reaction in which single reactant breaks down into simple products.
Yes.
Now you can see hydrogen peroxide decomposing to give H2O plus oxygen. Water upon decomposition gives H2 plus oxygen. All these things you can see the one reactant decomposes to give 2 or more products. Thank you. noted down all these examples?
Yeah.
Okay, before I proceed ahead, let us discuss some questions based upon this. Okay, now answer this question. Oh, I have not shared.
Wait. No, sir.
Whenever you find I haven't stopped sharing, just let me know. Okay, tell me, which represents the chemical change? Yes, Arav, Nippon.
So is it cooking of food?
Cooking of food, okay. Is it chemical change? Yes. And sulfur into carbon disulfide, what about this? Sulfur is converting to carbon disulfide. Chemical, it's also change. So I can say both B, C, and D are chemical change.
Dissolution means change.
Okay, dissolution. No. Dissolution means dissolving. So we are not dissolving it. No, upon dissolving, there is no chemical change. Leave it.
Yeah.
Only cooking of food is, yeah. Okay. Tell me the answer. Yes.
So is it option C?
Yes. Right. Option C is the correct answer. Right, it burns with the dazzling white light. Okay, then answer this now. Saksham, Arav or Nippon, you tell me.
So is it AR2SO4?
D option. Al2SO4 whole thrice. This is the correct answer. Note it down. Al2SO4 whole thrice. Do you know how to make it? How to make the answer? How to make the formula?
Cooking of food.
Aluminum has the outermost three electrons are there, right? And sulfate has two negative. So you can cross multiply and get the answer. So Al2SO4 whole thrice. Okay. The abbreviation used for a substance dissolved in water. Which abbreviation do you use when something dissolved in water? Yeah, something dissolved in water. Suppose I say sodium chloride dissolved in water, then I get here Na positive AQ. AQ means dissolved in water. AQ dissolved in water. Understood?
Yes.
Work upon this question now. I showed you that experiment, zinc granule and dilute hydrochloric acid. What do you observe? Which is incorrect observation? Question is, which is incorrect observation?
So is it option D?
Yeah, option D. When the chlorine is not liberated. Right? What happens here is zinc react with the hydrochloric acid. We get here ZnCl2 and hydrogen gas. And this hydrogen gas, that this is observed, this is an exothermic reaction. So energy is released. And this hydrogen forms a bubble that rising from the surface of the zinc granules. So all these are there. So chlorine gas is evolved is a wrong statement. You tell me the answer now. A chemical equation is a symbolic representation of...
Sorry, chemical reaction?
Yes, chemical reaction. Yes. What happens when dilute hydrochloric acid is added to iron filling? Iron plus HCl. We get here FeCl2 plus hydrogen gas. That is the balancing equation. So this is the equation that I am telling you. Note down the equation and tell me what is the right answer now.
Sorry.
Option A, correct answer. Right. Just note down the equation. Fe plus HCl to give FeCl2 plus hydrogen. Yeah, give the answer now. The substance which undergoes chemical change in a reaction is called. A substance which undergoes chemical change in a reaction is called.
So is it reactants?
Yeah, reactant. Yeah, you're right. Now, for this question, I will give you some theory detail. Just wait a minute. What we do, we take up sodium chloride aqueous solution. Aqueous solution means when dissolved in water. The symbol for that is AQ. AQ means when dissolved in water. And now I'm adding silver nitrate aqueous solution. When I say aqueous solution, it means in the aqueous solution they are already in the form of their ions. We are adding here silver ions and a nitrate ions. They exchange their ions such a way that silver combines the chloride ion and sodium combines the nitrate ion. And we get here sodium nitrate, NaNO3, and AgCl. When you get the AgCl, that gets precipitated. Precipitated means in the test tube, we get a floating mass of AgCl. This is a white color precipitate. I'm writing with the red, but it is a white color precipitate. And this remained dissolved in water. When the precipitate is formed, precipitate means when dissolved in, when you're mixing it, the product formed either start floating up or get settled down. Either get floating up or get settled down. We call this is a precipitation reaction. We call this is a precipitation reaction. Right. Note on this reaction here. This is called a precipitation reaction. Instead of writing PPT, I can write the symbol like this. This indicates that it is getting precipitated. Downward arrow. Note it down. So, what is the right answer here?
So that would be.
Yeah. Okay, now I'll talk about the single displacement reaction first, right? I'll tell you about the different reactions. I have taught you till now, I have taught you about the decomposition reaction only and the combination reaction only. Now, before I go ahead, let us talk about the different types of the reaction, decomposition reaction. Thermal decomposition means decomposition by the heating. Calcium carbonate upon heating gives calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So it gets decomposed upon heating. So we call this is a thermal decomposition. Just write this example only with this term. Thermal decomposition means heating decomposition when reaction is carried out by the heating. When reaction is carried out by heating, it is called as a thermal decomposition reaction. Note it down. So we have a lead nitrate in this test tube, in this boiling tube. We are heating it. What do you find? The violet color gas, brown violet color gas comes out of the nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. This is the decomposition reaction upon heating. So just note down this equation and the balancing. Just note on the equation, lead nitrate formula, upon heating it gives PbO plus NO2 plus O2. Note it down. Note it down, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, see here in this container, I have water and I'm passing current. by connecting with the battery. And in this test tube, I'm finding here the production of water and the hydrogen here. So basically this water get decomposed to give hydrogen and oxygen. You just balance it, you get this equation. Right? This is the water is getting decomposed by passing current. We call it is the electrolysis of water. Electrolysis of water, electrolysis. Electro means we are passing the electricity, and that brings the lysis, means breakdown of water. We call it say electrolysis of water. Similarly, silver chloride, this is silver chloride, decomposed by the sunlight only, we get this thing. This is called as a photochemical decomposition. This is called as a photochemical decomposition. Decomposition in the presence of light is called as a photochemical decomposition. Got it now?
Yes.
Yes.
So in the presence of sunlight, it is decomposing. Similarly, silver bromide also get decomposed in the presence of sunlight. This is called as a photochemical decomposition. Decomposition in the presence of sunlight is called as a photochemical decomposition.
Yes.
No. Wait. A solution of substance X is used for whitewashing, right? Write the name of the substance X and write the formula. Calcium oxide is used, right? Write the reaction with water. When it reacts with water, it forms calcium hydroxide. Right? This is called the quick lime. And this is called the flaked lime. Can you tell me what type of reaction it is? What type of reaction it is? When two or more reactants are combined to give some product, what type of reaction it is? Can you tell me? Saksham?
Can you repeat?
What type of reaction it is? It is a decomposition or it's a combination, what?
Combination.
Good. It's a combination reaction. Have you noted down, everyone? Arav? Nipun?
Yes, sir.
All right. I'm stopping sharing for some time. Okay, any doubt till now? Right. So whenever a reaction takes place here, we find, wait a minute, please. Let me share my screen again. See now. Till now, whatever we have discussed, whenever a chemical reaction takes place, that chemical reaction is accompanied by what? Number one, change in state. Number one. Number two, change in color. Right? What more? Change in heat. It may get heated up. It may get cold. Any other change? What change do you, what more you can observe here? Change in state, change in color, change in heat. What more? Yes, Arav. Change in state, change in color, change in heat, what more? Yes, Arav, fourth point. Chemically, new product is formed. New product is formed. Right. Whenever a chemical reaction takes place, what I had discussed till now is
that. Still now, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
I was trying to tell, but I don't think you will be able to hear me.
Yes, yes, I can hear you, sir.
Sir, it's Arav here.
Yes, Arav.
So could you hear me before?
No, I was not able to hear you.
But over here, it was telling that I'm already unmuted and now speaking.
I was not able to hear you. You are
okay, sir.
Okay. Do you want to ask anything before this?
No. No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. You are only responding to my questions, right?
Huh?
You are responding to my questions.
I was responding, but I don't think you could hear.
Yeah, I could not hear you. You're not audible to me. Anyways, do you have any doubt? You can ask me now. No doubt. Nipun?
No, sir.
No. Saksham?
No, sir.
No. Okay.
No, sir.
I'm sharing my screen again. So I was telling you that during a chemical reaction, what do you find? Change in color, change in taste also, right? Change in taste, change in heat, all that is observed. And whenever reaction takes place, one, the starting material is called a reactant and it is converting into product, right? I told you one experiment today, that is burning of magnesium. What do you get upon burning? What do you get? Burning magnesium. You get a white color powder, you call it a magnesium oxide. But along with that, you can find white dazzling light is produced. So these two are the reactant, and what you get after the chemical change is called as a product. This is called as a product, reactant and product. What do you call this type of representation? what do you call this type of presentation? I have told you today. When I'm writing like this, magnesium plus oxygen in this words, then what do you call this equation called? What do you call this equation? Yes, Aksham.
So the type of equation?
No, it is called the word equation.
Oh, I thought you're asking the combination.
Yeah, no, it is a word. I'm not asking you about type of the reaction, but I'm saying what do you call this representation of a reaction? This is called a word equation. But when I write the symbol here, magnesium, MgO, now you balance it. So what do you call this equation? What do you call this equation? Symbolic representation, right? Symbolic representation. Also called a chemical equation, but in the form of the symbols. What is the physical state of magnesium, Arav? What is the physical state of magnesium? Solid, liquid, gas, what? What do you call it? Nipun?
So magnesium is in a solid state, right?
Yeah, solid, yeah. And oxygen is a gas. And this we are getting as a powder. So I can say solid but powder form. Right? Okay. What type of reaction it is? I'm giving you options. This is a decomposition reaction. Option one. Second, I'm thinking it is a combination reaction.
It's a combination.
Combination reaction. How do you define combination reaction, Taksham?
So it's like it's combined.
Two or more reactant molecules, when combined together and give one product only, it is called as a combination reaction. You can see two reactants are combined together and give rise to one product only. This is called as a combination reaction. Am I clear now?
Yes.
So that reaction in which two or more reactant combine to give one product is called as a combination reaction. Okay. Now, have you seen the chalk in your classroom? White color. Have you seen a chalk in your classroom? White color chalk? Used for the near whiteboard or green board? Yes or no? Can't hear you.
So seen what?
Chalk.
Yeah.
What is the chemical formula? It's a calcium carbonate. Write it down. Calcium carbonate. It is solid. If I heat it, this symbol for heat, this triangle is symbol for heat, right? I get here calcium oxide and I get here carbon dioxide. This is solid and this is a gas. What type of reaction it is now? What type of reaction it is? Yeah, tell me what type of reaction it is. Again, give the same option A and B, decomposition or composition or a combination.
Decomposition.
So,
thermal decomposition.
Very good. This is thermal decomposition. Why are you calling this a thermal decomposition?
So, because it has the heat symbol.
Yeah.
Which is a triangle.
Yeah. It is a heat that decomposes it, right? Are you getting these chemical equations? So basically, till now, right? Till now means till your eighth class standard, right? Eighth standard, you are just reading the words only, that this combine, this react, or this something. This is happening change here, but now we are representing it in terms of symbols. The symbolic representation of a chemical reaction is called as a chemical equation. Chemical equation, symbolic representation, right? So now onwards, we will be representing every phenomena taking place in the chemistry lab in terms of symbols. Okay, before I proceed ahead, right, I'll tell you about the formula, how to write the formula. Do you know the symbol of the elements, yes or no? Symbol of element. If I say what is symbol for the hydrogen, do you know what is the symbol for hydrogen? Arav? Yes or no?
So symbol of what?
Symbol for hydrogen.
So H.
H. Okay. Okay, just a second, please. Symbol of carbon. Symbol of carbon. Keyboard responding. Nippon.
Sisti.
T. Okay. So you know the some symbol of elements here, right? Symbol for aluminum is Al. Okay. Now, what is the atomic number of aluminum?
So 13.
13. Electronic configuration, what do you think? Electronic configuration. Saksham.
So, 2.
2.
With.
8, then next what?
3.
3. So it'll lose electron or gain electron? During the combination reaction, during any chemical reaction, it'll have tendency to lose electron or gain electron. It'll tend to lose electron, right? This electron, 3 electrons are lost. So after losing electron, that will acquire a 3 positive charge, right? It has lost 3 electrons. Okay, getting me? And if I talk about the oxygen, atomic number? I'm not getting your response. Fast. Oxygen atomic number.
So 8.
8, yeah. So what is the electronic configuration?
2-6.
If it is more than 4 electron in the outermost shell, right, that will have tendency to gain electron. Now to complete the octet, to get the complete octet, how many electrons it will gain now? It needs total 8 electrons. 6 are already there. So how many electrons it will gain more? Yes? Now, how many electrons it will gain? To get the complete 8, how many electrons does it need more to complete the octet? It already had a 6. To get the 8, how many electrons does it need more? Saksham?
2.
2. After gaining 2 electrons, what charge will come on the oxygen now? What charge will come on oxygen now?
it should be no charge.
Two negative charge, right? O2 negative charge. Now, if I had to combine the compounds of aluminum and oxygen, right? Aluminum with a 3 positive charge and oxygen with a 2 negative charge, they just combine like this, O here and 2 negative here. So the compound will be now Al2O with a 3. This compound is called the aluminum oxide. Note down how to write the formula of any compound. How to write formula of any compound. Got it now? Now, if I say I had to make a compound of the magnesium chloride. My pen is not working. Magnesium chloride. Here I have two elements. One is the magnesium and second the chlorine. Magnesium atomic number? 12. Okay, speak out fast. What is the electronic configuration? Electronic configuration of magnesium? Saksham?
So 282.
Okay. 282. So how many electrons it will lose or gain? What do you think? If it is less than 4 in the outermost shell, it will lose, right? So how many electrons it will lose now? These two, right? To get the complete octet, you can get the 8 electron after losing electron. So when it loses here 2 electron, it will acquire magnesium with a 2 positive charge. And chlorine, atomic number is 17, electronic configuration is 2, 8 and 7. In the outermost shell, when the electrons are greater than or more than 4, it'll gain electron. Now it'll gain only one electron so that it can have now complete octet 288. Okay. After gaining one electron, become now 288. So now what will happen here? Magnesium is having two positive charge and chlorine is having one negative charge. Now make a cross multiplication and tell me the formula now. This will come here, this will come here, minus one will charge come here. Now tell me the formula now. Tell me the formula now. Mg with a 1 and Cl with 2. Getting me? So magnesium chloride is MgCl2. That's how we make the formula. Understood till now? Nepon?
Yes, sir.
Right. Saksham? Any doubt till now? Arav?
No, sir.
Okay. Fine. So today you have learned how to write a chemical equation. What do you mean by the word reactant product? How to write the formula of a compound? During any chemical reaction, what changes are observed? Right? Okay. Want to ask anything now? Till now?
No, sir.
No. Okay then. Now I'll be sending one homework. Do it. You will get it on the platform only, on the homework section only. So do it and send it to me. We'll discuss it next time. Right? Okay then. I'm ending session now.
Yeah. Okay. Umesh sir,
yes, sir,
I will interrupt here. Sorry for that. With your due permission, can I share one practice, like few practice sheets which students are supposed to do?
Sure, sure. Sir.
Right. What I'll do now, I'll take next couple of minutes to show them, because we will be coordinating with their parents also.
Sure.
They have asked specifically to give the worksheets as well.
Sure.
Right. Apart from the homework. So this is a course which we have assigned. This is so students can actually practice it on their own. So any one of the student can confirm me whether you're able to see my screen or not. Nipun, Arav, any one of you? Saksham?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, this look at the course. This class 9 smart science assessment course. Okay. So some of you would have got science or both combo of math and science both. Okay, if you have not got, then you just get back to us. We will give you. But I have personally given the access to all of you, right? So you have to open the class 9 Smart Science Assessment course, right? In that, you will see the demo test, right? This is only one test. Now, after that, you see there are two test series, right? One is Smart, this is Science Assessment Pro Plus, and second is Science Assessment Plus, okay? So these are basically tests. So once you open it, na, whatever chapters you have covered, right, you'll see this is whole physics, chemistry, bio, all inclusive, right? So suppose you are doing atoms and molecules today, right? So sir, with due permission, with your permission only, once we complete any chapter, na, you can ask the students to complete the exercise of these chapters.
Sure.
These are already prepared, and these are like hot level questions will be there, right? So suppose this assessment is there, atoms and molecules, students simply have to open it, take test, right, and submit it. So whoever faces any issues, suppose any conceptual issue about the question, they can come back and discuss with you in the next class.
Yeah.
Right, sir.
Right. Perfect.
Right. So this is what you can always suggest the students once we complete any chapter.
Mm-hmm.
So these exercises they can do, and it is best part they can do at their own pace. Need not actually do it at certain time. Right. This is always available to them.
Right.
Okay, sir.
Right.
So today, which chapter we have covered, sir?
We have already covered atoms and molecule and structure of atoms.
Okay. Two then chapter. You can ask them to complete these two chapters.
Yeah. See. Yes. Saksham, all of you just open and do these two chapters now. Right. They're very easy. I think very short. They don't have much questions. Like only for 10 questions or 20 questions are there on each assignment. You can do it. Right. Next time, if you find any difficulty, let me know. I will discuss in detail with you. Right.
Right.
Okay. Fine.
Students, is it okay?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Okay, thank you. Okay, sir, thank you. Okay. Thank you for
thank you, sir. Okay, see you next week now.